YouTube is this chick. If you go to Positive Smash 420, she from Oregon. Well, no, she from Washington. And she, like, sampled all the weed, moon rock, every fucking, like, strand of everything. And literally, it'd be, like, $9-$10 for, like, the best
two, three grams. Like, it'd be, like, 2-3 grams.
Pre-roll blunts with keef and wax and weed already in there. That's $10. 0.75s, and then you pay like 15 or 20 for a 1.25.
So that means for a quarter.
Right, that's why I said I'm living on this. Like, as soon as my case, me and Kev was talking about it, when I went home,
you can smoke here. There's nothing wrong with smoking here. It's just the fact that you get tired of, like, oh, I got that gas. Where you can go somewhere where you can actually get the name.
I'm getting tired of
niggas. And you can actually study what you get right, and be like, oh, yeah, this is what it's right.
Niggas here have some OG Kush, and then niggas like three streets down, I had the same OG Kush, be like, nah, I got some Fruity Pebbles, but like, bro, this shit look exactly the same.
Let's be real, niggas in the hood ain't studying no THC. Niggas they just trying to see how cheap they can get their house. They not looking to, you
said it perfectly the other day, bro. Weed changes hands so much. You feel me? Like, a lot of niggas is getting their shit if they even know where they getting their shit from. Because you might, like, if you selling zips, you might be getting your shit from somebody who sell pounds. Which, if he sell pounds, you don't even know if he's getting it directly from somebody out of town or he's getting it from a grower.
And you hope you is getting it from somebody out of town. Because
you hope you getting what you really say.
Right, because if you getting it from here, you like, well.
There's a nigga can tell you got anything. Right. You got Snickle Fritz.
Because you already know if you getting it from somewhere here, it's homegrown. Yeah, if they like, oh, it's on Ohio. We ain't got no dispensaries, nigga. This is homegrown.
I mean, like, no, we
don't hit me wrong.
This is some good shit.
But you roll the dice every time with it. You know, you
hate drugs.
It's about to be legalized here soon, and we is getting a lot of people.
You think so?
I know niggas who literally are working with the petitions and getting buildings together and all of that shit for dispensaries and for all of that shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it's going to be here within the next 5 to 7 years. If that, it's just, so I know that there is niggas who are not only, because they got to get everything lined up. They got to get, right now, the reason why it's not going to be legalized is because if it's going to be legalized, there's going to be an instant monopoly on it. There's only like 3 to 4 people. This is from the information I got from the guy who I know who does it. And so I'm speaking from third party, so I don't know exactly. But basically, if it was to be legalized now, there's only like 3 to 4 people who actually have all of their ducks in a row to be able to distribute it. So it would be a monopoly as of right now. So they're trying to get it to where, like, well, let's get it to where there's less, I guess, contingencies keeping more people from doing it. Mm-hmm. Like, so more people can do it, so that it's not only a couple people that can sell it, and then they own all the profit. Because that's how, like, electricity and shit is now. Like, if it's only 4 people that can sell it, they name the price. So then we won't, we'll be like, well, shit, $50 a gram. Like, fuck you, go to the 3 other people who got it. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's just, they trying to get more shit together.
I think it's just a little bit more difficult to be legalized here, because it's not no pressure here to get it legalized. Like, the population is decent here. They ain't losing people. Everything is cool, so they trying to make the most money. The government want their piece of this.
That's
here.
All like, it is.
That's simple here. They not gonna just let it ride and get free here, and they don't get a piece of the pie.
Yeah.
They like, no, we getting some of it. Because when they did it on the vote the first time, the reason it didn't go through is because it was such a large percentage for the government, and they had such a hand in it. It was like, yeah, it's gonna be legal, but they taxing. And you're going to basically be able to get it from one
That's
source.
That's going to be every trip. That's the only reason why weed's been illegal in the first place. They said that on Family Guy. Weed was only made illegal in the first place because they felt like if weed was legal, then people was going to make paper out of hemp. And there was already a monopoly on paper. There was already people that owned the way that paper was made through trees. And if they legalized weed and we could make paper from the hemp that's in weed, the stems in weed, it was going to fuck up the paper industry. So they was like, fuck that. It's illegal. Like, it's already a drug, it's a psychedelic, and it's gonna fuck that up, you out. Like, but now, you know what I'm saying, with it being having medicinal uses and then also all the different other uses like that, not to mention there are jobs in it, you know what I'm saying? It's not only just a way to create profit, but there's also industry in it. And Ohio is a place where, shit, we got all the motherfucking call center jobs and shit like that. Like, it's another way for the government to definitely make money. They just trying to figure out the perfect amount of money for them.
Yeah, it'd be a huge step for the Midwest if a Midwest state was to get fully legalized. I could see all the Midwest states getting medical, of course, but recreational, that's going to be tough. Because we so, it's so more lenient out west than it is
here.
Once you get in the Midwest, it's more strict, you know.
Isn't it medicinal here, though? It's something here.
No.
Nah, it's medical up in Michigan. But they don't even got recreational.
I swear something, they had some.
The only medicinal places is like Oregon that you can get that's recreational is like Oregon, Washington, California,
we don't have anything here.
Colorado. It's all West Coast.
I know we ain't got no dispensaries. Yeah. I thought that there was a roll on. I don't know. I'm sure. I thought there was a roll on.
I heard it was.
Even my grandma said some shit about it.
Yeah, like my grandparents.
Grandma, how you know about this shit?
Man, cuz Monte Williams, man, like, listen, my grandparents, it was the biggest advocates for me not smoking. Now I got MS, they're like, yeah, smoke, it's legal. Now, like, you can go, all you gotta do is get your doctor to try to get you some. You know, Monte Williams smoke. Like, he got MS, he smoke, he said it helped him out.
He got MS, he smoke.
I'm like, wow.
Just think about it.
So this old ass, bald ass nigga, the only reason y'all allowing me to smoke is this old ass.
Who gives a, do y'all even watch Monte Williams?
Right.
Does that shit come on to right?
This nigga just bald as fuck with that one earring, like.
Shut the fuck up.
I don't even remember. Monte Williams was the black guy. The bald guy, right?
With the hoop earring.
I don't remember the hoop earring.
He just had a show just to be happy. Nobody watched
it. Really didn't have no theme. Like, it wasn't like Maury where niggas was not the father.
It was like one of them. It was like a Dr. Phil. It was Dr. Phil before Dr. Phil. It was Dr. Phil literally just came and took over.
I don't even think it was Dr. Phil.
He was not helping. He didn't help. He just was talking about it.
It was like the, literally, it had to be like the lowest show they had. Because it was, Ricky Lake was more
Ricky
popular
Lake,
than
bro.
That.
Shout out that
Jerry Springer was more popular than that. Maury was more popular than that. Oprah was, we ain't even got to talk about that. Literally, nobody watched Montel. Even that one white lady got more. That Sally Raphael, whatever her name was, that bitch even had more.
Speaking of shit like Jerry Springer and motherfucking Maury, which, by the way, I love. And like,
Kyle,
it's horrible to watch Maury. It is Kyle. That nigga's an asshole.
That nigga's an asshole.
Kyle is that. Bro, this nigga, bro. This girl, she motherfucking. I guess her nigga or something. It was white nigga. But I guess he was cheating on her or something like that. So they was on the episode before this episode. And I guess he had been dogging the dude out. So on this episode, they not only find out that the baby that she had wasn't his baby. She had been cheating on him. He was like, so you sat here and had me on the last episode yelling at this man, going in on him. And you ain't shit. I'm like, this nigga crazy.
Yeah, man.
He said, bitch, you need to get real. I was like, what?
You can't tell this bitch.
Kyle says whatever the fuck he... My mom watches that shit. Like, I think because I'm getting older and, like, I'm a parent now. You feel me? I'll be, like, consuming a lot of that shit that my mom, like, now I'm into the soaps and shit. I ain't never think I was going to be... Well,
not
the soaps go down, but I'm gonna fuck.
I ain't gonna cap. I got caught up in the soaps one day. I was over my mom's house.
You don't supposed to get caught up. You just don't.
Bro, but listen, you right? Like, wait,
it'd be
hard.
Like, it'd be crazy.
You know my situation at home.
Yeah.
You know my situation. Yeah. My grandfather got Cowboys and Indians on downstairs TV. You feel me? That's close. My grandma got the soaps on in her room, and so it's just my little ass TV. That don't, like, all the shit, only one HDMI port. That's the only thing that works on the TV. Only thing, and the buttons on the side. No channels, can't put the cable cord in there because it's fucked up. So I can't, that TV's just shitty. So there's no, I had to pick and choose. I watched some Suns before, and I watched some Cowboys. I done seen enough Cowboys.
That's crazy.
The soaps is shitty.
I do gotta get in there because Cowboys is like so.
Listen, boring. And I done seen everything, bro. I done
never
seen,
watched a Cowboy anything.
Bro, because you ain't never been my, you ain't never kicked it at my grandparents' house, bro. When you go to my grandparents' house, it be a rainy day if you got it on Sci-Fi or TNT.
What's up, Stash?
What's up? What's good? It's popping. Stash.
I don't know. Westerns is...
Like I said, like, the stuff that you got caught up in, that's more my grandma bought. That shit gets so motherfucking real. Sisters, that used to be a nigga, and I was your bitch, man, shit was crazy.
That shit was crazy. And they was all in the one room. He was like, man, that'll never be our baby girl. We don't want... I'm like... Oh, fuck! Shit,
right.
Damn, she used to be a nigga. It's too much. It's too much. I can't deal with
it. And it's another one where this white girl who don't, like, she worked with her neighbor and they all fucking the same.
She's
nigga.
Definitely deep in the soul.
She had a scope. Like, bro, listen, it goes down, bro. Like, I'm an old ass nigga, I be bored, bro.
He said, I'm an old ass nigga, freaking me out watching some.
And, when they, like, you feel me? When hours didn't match up, y'all niggas at work, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Both TVs, and I'm not watching no more fucking black and white Cowboys. Bro, have you ever seen a black and white cowboy show in HD, nigga?
Somebody get this nigga out of here, man. He said, have you ever seen a black and white cowboy show in HD, nigga?
Like, real rap, bro. Like, grandpa, you guys, my mom, you guys, anybody. My girl, my baby mom, my girl, any girl I ever dated, my baby moms, anybody that's ever been inside my grandma's house and kicked it, they can tell you. Yeah.
You got the viewers out there asking real quick while I say who you are again.
Like, I literally was just trying to get the same way that.
Yeah, I was going to people asking.
I know, it's...
They're like, who is Baby Girl? That's some chocolate.
Hey, who is that?
Like, damn, know? Who that shark?
Hey, is that the dude you're desking?
_Lala_TheLion on IG and Lala_TheLion on Twitter.
So we do have a very, very rare feed. Rare.
And wherever else you want to find me.
Everybody shout out to Bear Stash. Shout out to Addicted. Addicted Terry.
This nigga can't read. Yes.
<It's> Terry.
Hey, shut up. I ain't shit.
we got a very, very rare treat, man. We do got Lala Line in the building with us, man. One of the up and coming, blossoming, beautiful models that we have in the city right now. So
thanks, guys.
Yeah, you're very well. So how are things going? I know everything is fruitful, but just, you know what I'm saying, just tell us, like, how is your journey right now? How you feeling right now? Like, what type of space are you in? Like, how you feeling?
I feel fucking great. My journey right now is flourishing. Not only am I elevating, like, what I'm doing every day, I'm booked and busy. It feels fucking great. I stopped doing shit for free.
Hey.
To be honest, I focused all this year of just building my brand. And that's exactly what I did. I've been networking like crazy. After building my portfolio, I no longer wanted to work for free because my work spoke for itself. And I'm getting booked.
Hey.
I have three jobs.
Let's go.
I'm in love. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything's just great. I can't complain. I'm blessed.
They're saying it's dry. Hit that
bomb. Yeah, oh, you already know, Mikey. You already know your boy Mikey D from the East Coast. I'm going to go ahead and do that. But you touched on something that some of the viewers might want to know. You said you're in love, so there's a special guy out there.
Come on,
so y'all niggas better back the fuck up off my sister, nigga.
Yeah.
Niggas, I pissed the work, nigga.
Bro, you know who that nigga is. If you see me out and you try to talk to me, you know what's up.
I ignore everyone.
And it's just because I have a hoe man.
Yeah, she got a man. She is trying to be rude, you feel me? You know,
I'm being rude, yes. I'm being very rude.
She let
being
me.
Being very rude. So rude. Not friendly. But don't talk to me.
Yeah,
but if you want to support the vision, that's great.
So, like, when did you really start, like, on your journey? Like, when did you realize, like, you know what I'm saying? All right, cool, you feel me? I got my swag. I enjoy, like what kind of sparked it initially and let you know, like, you, like, wanted to do modeling full-time? Like, what do you think that moment was?
Well, you know, all my life, like, everyone in my family has been saying I need a model. Mm. But, you know, me, growing up, I was so rebellious that I didn't want to do what everyone said I should do.
Facts.
I actually wish I would have started younger so I could be perfect now. You know, like, yeah, I'm good, but it's still some things that I have to work on, and that's just me being the way I am, you know? Mm-hmm. But I just feel like when I started really being serious is when I grew up. And that was last year.
Okay. Was there a moment, an opportunity, or a certain person?
When remember when we worked at PCCW, mm-hmm. and we was in Kroger,
and PCCW. The dude was like,
"Fuck PCCW."
Well, fuck them.
Fuck PCCW.
But listen.
He said, "Yeah."
If y'all ain't noticed, we all worked at PCCW. I just shot
him over here thinking that was my first call center job.
We was making some good money there. We was making
some good money at the age.
That was a lot of bitches.
But we know. Everybody in there. You're
what? Oh, man.
Sorry.
Oh, my God. Put him in the coffin. Hey, it was East Coast. It wasn't.
He about to pull up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Listen.
Look.
Back to school.
When that guy was stalking me in Kroger, and I thought he was trying to kidnap me, and he was actually trying to get me to meet with Karen Siegel, and I met with Siegel, and you know what, bro?
Yeah, I think y'all remember that name. That ended up being something good for you, huh?
You know what, it did, but we're not even going to get into all that, because that was the biggest opportunity of my life, and I should have just signed that contract, but you know, my mom said it was something weird about it, so I didn't sign. I would be famous by now.
I mean, don't always look at things like that. I mean, like, there's always an experience to learn and anything.
Yeah, but why didn't I sign it?
Because that's not what she was meant to do.
If it was what you was meant to do, you would have did it.
But it just wasn't your time. See, what the Lord does, what I've been noticing a lot with going through a lot of stuff that I'm going through, like, the Lord, He keep putting me in the same story over and over and over and over and over. But the thing is, like, you feel me? It's not that I'm missing opportunities. It's just, it's not my time. He want me to accomplish other missions. So, like, I'm thinking I'm supposed to be doing this, but I'm really, the reason I keep doing it over and over is because I'm supposed to be taking care of something else.
Yeah.
I just keep ignoring it. And then, you feel me? So, you just like me, like, the whole mama thing, like, you feel me? I tried it up for a little bit. My cousin Demetrius.
You can tell me model.
Like, my cousin Demetrius Lamont. Shout out me.
Oh, yeah, I'm model.
Yeah, that's my cousin. Like, when he first started, I was one of his first people. I was in them pictures, man. Putting them down. Making all them old women wet. You feel me? You feel me? But it was like, pretty boy be a thug. Pretty boy be a thug. You know I'm going with the thug.
Yeah, I'm going with the thug. So proud.
Like, bro, I can't be in a goddamn magazine violent. Like, I'm gonna have some bitches, but other bitches, the hood bitches I'll be waiting.
Nah, pretty boys got tried a lot.
You don't like hood bitches.
Huh?
You don't even like hood bitches.
Niggas want all the bitches. We want to have all the
You're
bitches.
Right.
You want to have all the bitches. He has the type, actually.
I don't want all the bitches. I have the type. Bad bitches just happens to be my type.
I knew that was coming. I was hoping you
I like pretty ass girls, bro. Like, I like pretty ass girls.
Nah, but, like, but back to your career, what I want to ask was, like, what made you honestly be like, you know what, fuck it, I'm full-time being a model. Like, what got you to that point? Because, you know, a lot of people want to do things, but they just like, I can't do it because I gotta get this in, I gotta take care of
this. Well, it's not necessarily like a full-time thing, because we still live in our reality.
I mean, I have three jobs.
I mean, yeah, I know you have three jobs, but what made you just, like, say, fuck it, like, I'm gonna be a model, so fuck it, I'm doing it. Like, literally just said, fuck it, I'm going hard for it. Like, I'm putting it all in. Like, what draws you to that moment, like that? Cause you know, we all talked, like, we all knew you did modeling. Like, I knew you back in the day, we used to do the little club pictures with all the girls and shit. But it was like, you always like teased it, like, it was just something you just did. It was like a check. It was just a check. Now it was like, it's not a check, it's a career. Mm-hmm. Like, so what got you to that point?
Because I'm passionate about it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. It's something that I love. Like, if anything, and you know that about me for real. Anything that I do, I'm not about to half-ass do it. I'm going to do it the fucking right way. So if I'm going to be out here saying I'm a professional model, I'm going to have cards for you. I'm going to have contact information. When you DM me or message me or email me or book me, I'm going to let you know my deposit. I'm going to let you know my small fee. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to be professional.
Yeah,
I'm building a brand. I'm building my name. I want people to know who I am.
I'm trying to get my interview skills together. That's why I'm asking the question. It's not for me. I know you. You feel me? We know you. But the viewers, I'm just trying to, you feel me? You're a guest on the podcast. You feel me? I'm just trying to get the world, you feel me, to know you. Like, it ain't shit. Like, I know you. You sis. So I know, like, we've been through the shit. PCCW. Man, I live that job. I live Jobs Can Talk.
Fuck that
up. So, like,
fuck that
up. Yeah, fuck them, but we had some fun.
We did. We
see
high as fuck every day. Got to work. Talk shit.
Take hour long lunches.
What? Niggas was late every day.
They used to offer unlimited overtime. We was really working like 120 hours, like really getting to it.
I ain't gonna cap, y'all was.
You hated it.
I ain't doing that. Hell yeah, I was. Listen, That was during the rise of Mikey D from the end, like, literally. When I was really,
rise and fall.
Yeah, like, I really started doing
that. Definitely was a rise and fall moment.
Like, it was
some shit.
It was the rise, like, the start of PCCW was the rise, and then the end of PCCW was, like, the fall, but then I kind of bounced back for a hot second, then MS happened. But, like,
it all happened.
Crazy as
like,
literally, like.
But, so, like, next 5 years, where do you see, like, Where would you envision yourself in, like, the next 5 years as far as, like, your career and what you're going to be doing as far as your brand? Like, just, you know what I'm saying? I would say, like, a reality and a fantasy, but nah, we live our dreams well. So what do you want to see yourself doing in 5 years?
No, I totally know where I'm going to be in 5 years, I feel like. Because I make a goal, like, I make goals for myself, like, everyday accomplishments. And I get into it. Like, everything I said I was going to do this year, so far, I've literally done it. So I feel like in 5 years, I will be done with school. Thank God. I have 2 more semesters, 8 more months. Let's get it. And then I will be probably where I'm from, which is California. LA, in a city somewhere, or either New York or California. I don't know which one. But just know, I'm going to get right to it.
Listen, will you
or I might be somewhere overseas interning. You just never know. But all I know is modeling is my first passion, yes, but I have to be realistic, because if modeling like kind of falls through for me, I need to have a plan B, and I have a plan C too. So yeah.
See, all y'all ladies, y'all pay attention. If modeling don't work, she got a plan B and a plan C. That means if shit fall through, don't twice. Fall through. She got a backup, in a backup, for the backup. Like, come on now. Like,
that way.
And she got hustle. And you can't beat hustle.
Like, hustle, loyalty, respect. What John Cena say? Like, man, y'all niggas tripping. Can't see me. Like, for me, like, that's smart. That's what I feel like a lot of females is missing out here today. You feel me? I ain't trying to dog our females. I'm just saying, like, that drive right there. Even niggas, even like for niggas, if we could just implement that fucking drive.
Yeah.
Cause like, I can speak for myself. Me, I'm one of them niggas that's like, I ain't got no plan B through fucking whatever. Like, plan A is what I got, cause it gotta work. That's how I look at shit.
I ain't gonna cap. I fuck with like, I mean, I've always been very versatile. Like, I feel like I could work for the rest of my life. I just know it would make me absolutely miserable. Like, I literally I would not feel. I wouldn't feel fulfilled. Like I wouldn't feel fulfilled in my life. Like I would feel like. I would just like I like in retrospect, I would always look back on myself like, bro, I was so talented. Like, how the fuck did this happen? Like, so I literally like I don't see no like, cause I know I can do other shit, and I know I'll use those tools, all of that shit that I learned in those different places, like BCCW, learning how to be a professional and talk on the phone, like, and shit, but articulating yourself and knowing how to have a conversation and learning how to, you know what I'm saying? You gotta, before you can lead, you gotta learn how to follow. If you're gonna run a business, you have to learn how associates move. You have to learn that niggas need breaks. You have to learn that niggas need to feel like they're in a good environment and their job is fun to come to and their bosses are approachable. Like, all of that shit comes from you firsthand. Like, this is how I felt, so I know how this person is gonna feel. You feel me? But, so I know that that shit is gonna play an important role, even out to the people that you meet. You know what I'm saying? You'll run into them later on in life, like, oh shit, we used to da 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 da. And they'll be like, yeah, I was working there to make money, but I really was passionate about this thing that kind of intertwines with your thing. Like, bet, let's link up and really get our shit popping. But, I still couldn't, I know that it gotta be this. Hey, we got some special guests in the building. Y'all got nice shoes on, so I'm gonna make a video. So, Ashley, Mark, you take your shoes off, Chelsea, you can keep your.
You look nice. You guys look cute. Hey.
What's wrong, Maury Jones?
I'm tired.
You
look like you just came from a jagged edge.
Right.
Let's get it.
Like your name for the
lovely couple, please, please, please.
There you go, Laura.
Dude, that feels so good to take your shoes off. My God.
Yeah, see? It worked out.
Well, I love you. Really.
Don't eat you out. We got some very, very special guests in the building. Mr., Mrs., both the Joneses in the building right after.
Right. What's that? Is that the Steve Harvey collection?
That's the Justin Timberlake.
The Justin Timberlake? Okay.
This
Ferrari boys. Nice. Ferrari boys.
Hey,
so we got the whole family up in here, man.
I want to tie. That's fucked up.
Yeah, man.
It's a good one.
Is that a bow tie?
That's a bow tie. I mean, it's still sweet. Like, everybody got, like, bro, everybody's swaggy.
He said,
like,
this is a clip one.
I was sorry when I opened it up and it was like a good one. I was like, dang.
You wanted to have it the hard way?
Because you can fluff it up a little better.
I had to look it up on YouTube. Like,
yeah. I always had my dad look at it like when he was doing school with me. Like, how you do it? I can do a regular side, but both like, I'm so screwed.
Nah, somebody gotta do that shit for me. And that's never been my thing. Like,
watch my Snapchat.
I learned it and then I did it for like 2 days and then just been on my memory, like changing tires, all types of stuff. Like, I've been taught things, but like me, if I have no interest for it, and me, I've always envisioned myself at the highest that I'm like, I'm about to be paid, so I ain't gotta learn this shit. Somebody gonna take care of this shit. Like,
I learned how to change.
Like, I used to tell my mom,
I cannot do it by myself, bro.
I used to tell my mom, like, I'm not doing that. Like, I'm going to the league.
Bro, no lie, bro. With that oil shit, I learned how to do my oil change. I was like, okay. Man. I spent just as much motherfucking money, though, changing my own damn oil. My oil is expensive as fuck, and I was like, I'm about to just have another motherfucking
deal. The kid, $14, bro. Oil change, like, $20.
But my car, has a different car, bro.
Oil synthetic, some bullshit, and it's like $90 for them to do it. But it's like $70 for me to do it. I'm like, $20 for me, I just really just sit here and not be stressed out and get my hands dirty.
Right, bro. Right. 4 hours for $20, $30. $20.
I'm taking I remember.
$20. And they feel everything else up.
I cussed my baby mama out of her.
She was like, I'm going to be retarded, bro. That's not.
I'm serious in the motherfucking plane crash.
Serious as a plane crash is a great line, though.
Like,
that's a great line.
That's terrible.
That's how serious you got so bad. That's how serious it is. That's how serious it is.
Inaccurate. It's very serious. But so, man, you know what I'm saying? We got this.
Can we thumbtack on this real quick, though? My nigga Mikey D's hairline is crispy as fuck.
Yeah.
I mean, I gotta say that to people today.
That's why I'm mad.
If I say I'm not smoking, they be like, what the fuck are you doing? You don't smoke. But then when I say I'm already high, they be like,
you smoked before.
No. I smoked before with G and like a few other people.
He lies.
I've never smoked with you, G. But you are a fucking bullshit. I'm cussing on the radio show. And I'm,
man. Bro, you, this is unedited, bro. We are talking about horrible things in this show, bro.
That, it goes down. This is.
We are talking about horrible shit. We've had some crazy topics on here.
Yeah, like.
We had some crazy. We talked about cussing in front of your parents on here.
Right. Remember that time I said, come guess when you're in front of my mom?
Bro, oh my God, bro. And that was the first time you and J-Mom realized that come guzzle was not something y'all should be saying.
It's like,
y'all was like, come guzzle, come guzzle. And your mom was like, We used to have all types of catchphrases. We used to say stupid shit like Sprite, Shakings, bro. We had everything, bro.
At one point, cum guzzle was the one that I just was saying it like crazy all the time.
Cum guzzle? Cum guzzle? Guzzling?
Guzzling up and down on?
Guzzling up and down on things. That's what I was like.
Funny.
Hey, so I was thinking we should shoot like a booty documentary because everybody has came a long way. Like, I feel old as fuck because I feel like I know Mari forever. Like,
bruh.
I feel like I watched Mari grow up. Like, he was like he was my little brother. Like, grow up. Like, all everybody.
I meet you and be like, man, he is my thing. And then one day you be like, damn, we old as fuck. That's what happened.
Like,
I just realized I've been out of high school for 10 years the other day,
bro. That's all, bro. Shit, like,
on
soul, like, even
man,
like, I was
2007, bro. 2007, I was like a junior, bro. It's 2017.
I was listening to Man in the City by Vern. I start thinking like,
what's your age?
I'm 25.
Okay.
I start thinking like, damn.
You always trying to calculate something.
she gotta make sure she just saw it. Like,
are you accurate?
Bro,
are you acting right now, Gerald?
Hey, if you say no terrible math, you just did.
I just did horrible math.
I did a terrible math.
I said 70 plus 30 was 90, bro.
Yeah, we
damn! I can't even try to make these all minus
9.
I tried to play it off like I didn't care.
I was like 30. Oh, 20.
Let me try to make sure G got the. I sent you a text message trying to get you to text the address, dude, but you never texted me.
Bro, my phone is recording.
Oh, what is that? Oh, damn, was it on
there?
Well,
all live, bro.
We live, baby. Peter, Piper, Pigga.
What you want to do with that, baby?
Well, man, you see on the Funimation, but that was a good video. When it was in Funimation, I was in the game.
Now, I only saw when it was on Jerry Springer, and the Jerry Springer niggas had to tackle the
brother. What is this right here?
That's Prime Roy.
Boom, gang, nigga, look to
came here solely for the pop, bro.
Hey, I want to see him try that one day and then get fucked up.
What's up, like, boom?
Don't work. Like,
alright, come.
But Boom Gang, like, he always gets away. I just want to see one day he don't get away. Like, right, he just trips.
Come to the back.
And then he catches that.
I've seen
the
police
officer do
that.
Like,
bruh. The FJ. What's the number or the letter?
It's apartment 13. Just step around the back.
Yeah, come to the back. You'll see it from the window, but I think it's 13.
That's not even that funny.
It's apartment ZICK, man.
What is that?
It's an
ZICK.
I don't see how that's funny.
That was hilarious.
But you better chill out, man. You better touch your head time, man. We on camera.
It was funny.
Dang.
Thank you.
You feel me?
Right, this girl had a flask at the wedding.
Yeah, I was like, you guys, she pulled the flask out for me. That's amazing, bro.
Got a flask.
Right, bro.
Support. She's got her to ring.
Support.
Yeah. Oh, oh my God.
I love it. I love it. That's why I know that you're friends.
My,
we was just talking about how you and me drive, and you'll be like, I put it in your pocket, like, never again, Chelsea. Never again.
I hate to do that, neighbor.
Yeah,
you
I'd be like this, like, so you know, that's why when they accuse me being loud.
You're loud as fuck.
They accuse me being loud, I don't say nothing, you know. They keeps be running back and forth fast as well.
Can't whisper. Such a
bad. We loud.
Yes, it go crazy. I'll be
I wouldn't want to be no salt spurking ass person. I'll be seeing people to be like that. I'm like, bruh, if you don't fucking talk, bruh.
I hate when
let me get it.
You yelling loud and G still don't hear it. He be like, what?
Bro, I'm like, bro.
He get mad at you when he finally hear you. Like, bro, what?
How you ain't just say that, bro? I'm like, yeah, that's what you wanted this whole time, nigga.
God,
bro.
Like,
my dad. Oh, sorry. Tell him I said what's good, 100 grand.
Joe said what's good, 100 grand. You good, baby?
That's crazy.
Yeah. See, this that mama phone right here. Shout out to Shorty, y'all. So shout out to
Shorty.
Did the shrimp quesadilla go crazy?
Come on, bro, come kick it, bro, please, bro.
He turned though.
Yeah, we're
both hell, nah, see? Y'all be hesitating.
We gotta
turn with 100. My bad.
Lori, I ain't never passing y'all nothing no more. Not only did I try to pass it to you, I tried to pass it to Chelsea.
I didn't understand, I'm sorry.
Bro, look, man, we already that's all we did. I'll be right back.
Gerald
got a sofa.
You got a
sofa.
Really? Is it nice?
It's pretty comfortable. Russell just told me last night that when he was on his way over here, he was like, oh shit, I'm so happy I'm going to G's house.
I wish we could do like group events like the basketball wise, bro.
We should have a reunion show. We got to come up with some drama first.
But we already got drama.
Yeah.
We already got drama.
We should do a reunion and just come with a bunch of drama.
It would be the best
off the top
show
of the head, like,
ever.
No, but you don't even remember when you smacked me at the party and be like,
first of all.
Wait, what? When?
Bro,
oh, so you don't remember that.
We got to play. Chelsea get to be the host.
No.
Chelsea, no, you got to write down those. At, you could.
I don't have no drama. I have one drama.
Right, no, you're the host. You're only watching.
So I don't have any drama.
No,
you just got to look at us very, immediate. Like, very, like, concerned when you hear
ask questions.
You got a very concerned.
You got to learn how to instigate when you ask these questions, though.
Just be sincere.
But, so, Gerald, when you said this, though.
You got to repeat what they said.
Yeah, you got to repeat.
So, Gerald, so.
Right.
You said that Mikey D was a bitch ass nigga.
You said that?
You got to just repeat it, but you got to be sincere. Like, so when you said that Mikey D was. You got to take notes too. You got to write it down. That way, when you read the horrible comments that you say, they can be like, she's reading it.
Right, so this
she's not even saying.
So you have to submit your stories first.
Nah,
so
you will be taking notes as we like when the drama is unfolding.
Oh,
like we write
some new drama.
You ever seen a Bad Girls Club or like a?
Well, we're gonna show you some reunion shows.
I did see not the reunion.
Love and Hip Hop.
I saw the show, not the reunion.
The last episode is where it'd be most ratchet because what they do is they play clips from earlier in the season of ratchet shit that happened.
Gerald, do you remember when something pooped on the steps?
Ooh, oh my god, I knew.
Oh, Playground Love! I do. And she tried, but she didn't, she know herself. Girl, you know you shit on yourself.
I don't know.
Playground
Love
literally kicked her off because she shit.
Oh, yeah.
She was,
okay, I was, no. See, I'm thinking we was talking about somebody
bad
for real.
Did she have to poop?
Well, on the show, she did. Yeah, no, she had to shit.
Clearly she had to poop.
That's what started all these shows
with
Love VH1 for real.
Flavor
Flav.
That's so sad.
He started all of this shit.
To be the
Shout out to Flavor Flav.
Shout out Flavor Flav.
One time for the one time.
I wanna have
He's still out here, he's still alive.
What's up, what's
we got more guests.
Good, what's good?
What's going down? What's going to come like in the water ladies got there. I ain't gonna make book.
I'm gonna take mine off.
My cousin Jerome. It's D, Jeff, Mikey D, my baby mom,
Lala.
Hi.
It's Allison.
I want to call him Tyrone so bad.
You're right. Tyrone. But every other Tyrone that you have met is generic. Your boy's authentic.
Ooh.
He's ain't never met another Tyrone. Bars. Bars.
Bar guy.
Bar guy.
Bar guy.
I'm a peepers.
Bar guy.
Bar guy.
Check this out. Now, this is the squad. It was a lovely wedding today.
Thank you.
Everybody's
so
great, man.
Club,
man. I'm gonna give me a tie.
Bruh.
You don't wanna tie. No,
I'm like, girls should wear dresses from now on.
Just
bro.
The tie.
I'm
bro.
So. What is after today, dresses. From now on, for every, all women, just dresses all the time.
All the time?
All the time.
I'm gonna need you to not say that again, because mine will do it for real, and I'll be mad sometimes, but sometimes it's not that.
That's what I was thinking about, because I was like, dang, I don't know how I feel if I'm walking around, my girl got a dress, but I'm gonna be like, you know, I wouldn't want my girl to be the only girl that can't wear a dress. Like, damn, all these other bitches wearing dresses.
Bro.
I want to kill my dress. I'm
yeah,
like, damn,
yeah,
man, you really
wear
be killing that dress.
All the time.
Though. Like,
yeah,
all the time.
Wear
dress
if a girl pick it up, then dudes pick it up. It's the same thing. But dudes pick it up, girls pick it up. So if girls picking up dresses, dudes picking up some other dapper. You know what I'm saying?
We
start dressing up more.
You gotta wear shirt and ties.
You shirt and ties.
Oh,
yeah. Shit, you know what I'm saying?
You saying just a straight swag.
I'm not straight though.
I
mean, I'm about to say,
yeah,
James.
Nah, I ain't talking about you, right? You right. I'm talking about a different level of dresses. Like, so you right.
But when
dress
clothes
be
so
hot.
But check this out. When you think about it, what other occasion or what other function do we really go to that requires
it? It ain't gotta be a function, bro. It could just be that. It could just be your swag.
Right. When do you see black people around all dressed up like that.
I wear button down. Remember when I used to wear button down suit jackets all the time?
No. But yours wasn't like, you was still playing with it.
Yeah.
You was still playing with it.
Because I mean,
you
I didn't
like
have like,
you would have like a chain with the chain thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, everybody had
yeah,
all the chains
exactly.
Up. Everybody had the wallet chain.
Yeah, did everybody have the wallet chain?
I did not have
the
wallet
chain. Okay, I had the wallet chain,
have
okay? I know.
I did not have
listen,
wallet chain.
Listen, wallet chain was not one.
Listen, when I was in
was
high school, whatever
oh
Lil Wayne had,
oh,
Lil Wayne had the scarves, I had every color scarf. I was scarfed up.
Yeah.
Lil Wayne had the wallet chain. When Wayne started drinking lean, I started trying to find all the lean. Like, I don't know what, I was in high school, Wayne was God to me. Like,
not God,
but you already know, like, he was,
just a little bit.
He was that nigga.
Right, he was that nigga.
I
was
Wayne Cassidy, a lot of niggas pick Wayne.
You pick Wayne, and you live in the same city as Cassidy.
Cassidy live in
the ethanol.
Know somebody
living
in Columbus?
I don't think it's Cassidy.
I think
it's
gotta be Quick.
Oh, I'm
gotta
sorry.
Be quick.
I know it's Cassidy Avenue.
I don't think it's
Cassidy.
I'm
sorry.
Tell me
Cassidy. Mark, didn't we see Cassidy one time in the Walmart? He was wearing all pink.
That's Cameron.
Did you?
Cameron used to live there because Cameron got a baby mom.
Cameron shouted out Ohio multiple times.
He did.
Mr. Ohio.
He shouted out right there.
I was with somebody, but
yeah,
I was
right there on the other side of the street watching that video. Like, man, I'm gonna be an egg.
Everybody started wearing pink.
Black Ken. I heard it fire.
Blue B got a new mixtape
called Black
Ken.
I heard it's fire.
Bro, he said he got like 5,000 songs, bro.
Like, Black Can?
No, like, all together. It's like, no, one of the mixtapes he said he dropped, man, he's going to like,
have like 800 songs.
Yeah.
No, I remember that. That was wilding out, but then he took a long little break. Yeah. And now he got
Black You should King. Take a break after like you drop 300 right. songs.
You can just tour.
Lil B made me happy. It ain't like, you know, I know he be talking about the bullshit, but sometimes he hit you with some shit.
Be like, I ain't gonna
Lil B said some shit.
I heard Lil B drop Free Wayne, and I was like, this nigga's crazy. Free Wayne, bitch, I'm screaming Free Wayne.
That's fine.
Lil B, my fucking name. I was like, what? Okay. So Lil B's this guy's name, huh? But I don't know, like,
I feel like I'm being judged right now. What happened?
I have to use the bathroom.
What?
Excuse me.
Get childish.
It's real fancy.
You are collecting.
You have a towel folded in a triangle over your regular.
Somebody else did.
Oh, okay.
I was like,
ooh, Gerald, fancy.
Somebody
that's
told me.
That's funny, because my mom's been asking me how I'm coming
in,
and I said, okay.
I like it when people call me the bathroom. I gotta keep it clean. I ain't going up to those houses, and they bathroom there. It's just...
You should keep it clean.
Nah, man, we did have a topic that we needed to discuss, since we got two lovely young couples in the building tonight, man. We want to talk about, she's still gonna be able to, y'all are all lovely, stop it.
Here's the only thing about a podcast, bro. Is your viewers and your listeners can't see how beautiful my woman is.
You got a camera right there.
Yeah, this is live right here.
This is live, bro.
Now you got to put on the camera.
That's why we tried to get y'all to migrate this way.
See how y'all got the bars?
We actually want y'all to be on the camera.
I'm good for the podcast. I ain't got no camera.
Y'all can't even see my love.
Nigga, we got two.
I don't know if I want y'all to see it. That's the thing.
See,
here's the thing. Is in order to keep a sacred relationship sacred, some things you can't always put out in the open.
Not even her looks.
How would y'all feel about nude beaches as couples?
Nude beaches.
Oh my god,
see, here's the only thing is
nude beaches.
Nude beaches, both of the words.
Nude naked beaches where the people be out there butt ass naked.
Got it. Nude beaches. How I feel about that? Not in the U.S., I feel like.
I'm talking, yes, of course, there are new beaches.
You go to Miami Beach, they be in there.
I'm not talking topless, I'm talking new beaches. Like, everybody be naked. You're not even allowed to be on the beach.
First of all, like, for real, new beaches, I feel like it's overrated.
I wouldn't want a motherfucker to go, but this girl one time, she told me, like, why the fuck not? I would love to be. I was like, what is that shit? There's gotta be shit right there. You can't just say that. You gotta say stuff.
I don't know, bro.
But now, bro,
she was like, hey, why is that a new beach? Be with the Bahamas or some shit, whatever the fuck, you be where a new beach is. I'd be like, alright. But that's the type of thing I was drinking my system right now. So sober me, I don't know.
I mean, I ain't got no problem.
Sober me,
like, I wouldn't want my girl out there.
I don't want myself. If you want me to show my ass,
it all depends on what type of relationship and what type of woman you have.
Yeah, cause some women like to be shown off, and some men like to show their women off.
And some women are okay with their man looking at another woman, knowing that she trusts him enough that it's not gonna go past the look.
You get what I'm saying? Because I'll be damned if I put myself in a situation that says, yeah, let me go ahead and go to the new beach with you, but then you catch me looking and you mad.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? No. And then how much is too much?
Right.
What's the limit?
And then how am I going to treat where everybody looking at you? Like, oh, hold up.
But it all depends on your woman look like mine. She's going to be pulling more girls than you. So I ain't got to be worried.
If I'm not okay with my girl being naked, then I'm not going to be. Like, I can't be mad if I agree to go. I can't be mad. We're not gonna go if I'm not okay with somebody looking at you. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a point where it's just like, you know, I'm even okay to an extent, bro. I'm even okay if I'm not around and you hit on my girl. That's expected. Dude's gonna hit on girls no matter what. You know what I'm saying? If I'm around and you hit on my girl, that's when it's respectful. That's when it's like, you know what I'm saying? That's a whole different topic. But
nah, that's the topic. You know that topic. Nah, but shit, nah, I feel you.
But it's that type of thing.
Yeah, with girls, like...
Thing, like, I don't, like, for real... Like, I agree with them. Like, it's all about your relationship, how comfortable you are with yourself and with your significant other, flat out. Me, I agree with him, like, shit, you looking, shit, I'm looking too. Like, don't trip. Don't trip. You ain't the only bad one.
Go ahead and look.
It's just all the relationship. It's all the like, relationship. Like, me, girl.
I don't want no sand in my ass. I don't, like, you feel me?
And that's also what, that's a whole like, laugh. That's a valid point.
At the new bitch, I don't want to be uncomfortable. I'm comfortable with my body, but I ain't trying to be uncomfortable on a beach. You feel me? Step on a shell. You like, oh, fuck. You falling. Just naked as fuck. You all over the beach. I can't, like, no. Like,
ball, he said balls falling all over the place. Like,
you know, fucking sit down, sit with a starfish and shit. Right. Oh, fuck.
Get in the water naked as fuck. Jellyfish stuck in that side.
These are literally, bro, like that, for you to go through this series of things at the beach is really, like,
why did we know your ass naked? Why did we wear clothes?
Right. Like,
we wear clothes all the time.
If you get asked to go to a naked beach and with your significant other, you are asking to put yourself in a lot of awkward situations that you have to be able to handle instantaneously.
And you got
to
explain that shit to your
communication.
Now it's coming back.
Like you said, it goes back to people who are comfortable with that type of shit. Like I said, there's a lot of people, like Jayvon said, he was like, I can't wait to get a motorcycle. Cause then I could just ride around with my sexy ass girl on the back of my motorcycle. And he was like, I'm gonna just make her wear motherfucking see-through leggings with some bright ass panties just so niggas can see her panties and be sweaty as fuck.
He's just trying to show his girl.
What about that is sweet? Like, I don't want to show my bitch.
I'm not really doing that.
But it's some dudes, there's like Jordan, he was saying that. He was like, yeah, look at her. I love it. Like, he loved that shit. Like, I'm like, I can't.
Like,
I don't know, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. You're setting yourself up. You like, oh yeah. Fuck on my bitch. And I was like, yeah. All right then. You know, just a joke. I mean, not even like, you know, like just like a
the world's
gonna be like, nigga.
Because some niggas, they be, some people be about it for real, some niggas be flexing, like, some niggas go, oh, no, like, man, you, that's who you fucking with, like, no, then, like, say it is what it is.
Nah, I never hesitate with my woman, like, if that's my girl, that's my girl, bro, like, I down there cry with my girl, like, bro, that's what, I'm very possessive about mine, like, bro, I'll really break your fucking jaw, bro,
don't cry. Mike said he can make himself cry on impact, but he told me he will cry about, like, random.
That's how you know you're a liar.
Duh.
When I was a kid,
yeah, challenge my man's credibility right now.
Challenge my man's cryability.
Nikki and cryability.
She said, "Do it right now." He was like, quick as fuck. I'm like, "Oh shit, he about to cry, girl. He about to cry."
like the whole cry on impact thing is like it's more of a situational thing. If I'm really feeling like going through the whole process, I live a deep ass life anyway, so it ain't shit to really just think about one situation. Like, feel me? I had two homies die like back to back weeks, little kid.
I can just, like, it's fucked up, but I can just instantly think about DeRon or Josh and impact and shit.
Shit.
But,
like, I'm not. Because he's talking about some dash shit right now. Y'all just not listening.
I mean,
like,
I'm
really,
though.
Like, he said, like, you're listening, but
if I'm trying to skip to the game, I'm like, if I see a girl, I'm like, and it's a whole squad of niggas, niggas gonna talk that rah-rah shit. Go ahead, because we can find out about that later on if y'all really want to, but go ahead and handle that. I'm just going to play my sympathy card. Why are you all over there by yourself?
I'm not fully understanding.
He basically saying that he will use his, like, he'll just play standoff and shit, act like he got an attitude, wait for chicks to talk to him, and then he'll just be like, no, but my nigga just died and shit, I'm just going through it right
now. No, don't tap. I can't stand
it. My nigga just lied. He'll just get bitches and just cry and get bitches, bro.
Secondly, bro, I think about my niggas every day. I wake up, my nigga Josh's obituary in his pictures in my room. I wake up, I talk to that nigga every fucking day when I'm at home. I ain't been at home in a minute, but every day I wake up, I pray to DeRon every day. I talk to them niggas every day. Anytime I'm smoking by myself, I'm smoking with them niggas. So I'm with them niggas.
Like, them was my niggas. Like, DeRon, that was my nigga. Josh, that was my nigga. So.
You gonna use it.
Yeah, because the little niggas will use me. If I die, y'all niggas better use me. Like, my nigga, like,
okay, I'm going.
But see, that's the only way people live on.
Like, but not to pick up bitches.
Not to pick up bitches, but if it's factual, it's factual.
First of all.
Facts is facts, bro. But I ain't about to be like.
No.
But
my nigga
Mikey
D died,
but
that
would
have been fucking
sad.
Bro,
he really was sad.
No, I'm not sad.
If it's genuine, it's genuine.
No, I understand, but like I said, I ain't got time. It's 15 other niggas over here kicking game. I want you just as bad as they want you. All my niggas looking at you. I gotta get you because I told them niggas I'm getting you.
But is there any part where
so,
you
got
a different move?
Bro, don't get mad because I got a trump card.
Here's why your trump card is a trump card, but it's not as much of a trump card as something else that you can provide.
Yeah, right. Like,
if you're bringing something to the table different than what them other 15 niggas is bringing to the table, you don't gotta look like a little punk by crying.
Right, but. For real, like, my people know me. I ain't talking about a chick that I'm trying to fight. I'm just talking about a chick. I just don't want you to be walking through the mall and see a girl and a whole bunch of dudes trying to holler at you with your friends.
And then you just break out in tears.
First of all, that would never happen. I wasn't paying attention to people like me. I ain't really friendly. Like,
you would never stop.
I ain't that. Like, nah.
I would just stop.
But that's hilarious. I'm gonna try that one.
You know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying to me, man.
What's up with your man?
I would just walk the fuck away.
Hey, get your pants.
We gonna talk about you later that day. I'm about to start crying, y'all.
No, I'm gonna have intervention cry. I'm gonna just stop.
Just hit him with my eye.
Just hit him with my eye. No, like, me, for real, I just be bullshitting. Like, for real, I'm at a stage of all my, like,
Mikey, he's just a phenomenal.
I feel like our conversation is about to come around.
For real, I be acting like when I be doing a lot of shit, I just be seeing if I can get away. Like, y'all just don't know. I done had a twin brother. Y'all niggas don't know shit. Yeah, like, bro, like, I just do shit just to see.
Yeah, that's what's funny.
But like, what my like, now I'm gonna say skill limit is like, I just be
wanting to
say
like,
yeah, like,
you wanna try your game. You shooting your shot, brother.
Shooting my shot.
All them guys, I ain't doing Audrey.
Just in the game. Nobody was shooting with
you. I'm testing my skill level. It is what it is. Like me, I was raised differently than a lot of people. But for real, my family schemed. Like, for me, it schemed on everything. Dinner, everything. Like, nigga, it's real, bro.
Like, you ain't eating if you ain't eating.
Bro. You turn your head, nigga, and you got chicken on your plate. A piece is gone, bruh.
Watch your shit flat out. Niggas, like, I'm dead ass. Ain't no telling. Niggas is laughing at you.
Right.
Grandma, like, so? You better eat? Nigga, you whining? Niggas still taking chicken.
It's right, still be happening, nigga.
I wouldn't tell a nigga. How old was I? I'm telling until like fucking 13.
He said, how old was I? Because I'm telling until like fucking
13. My dad was really telling me, I'm not going.
Oh, yeah.
My dad. My dad.
He got what he wanted.
My dad ain't alive, man. That nigga be high as fuck. Like, I love my dad. But my dad.
There wasn't no telling in
our house. Telling was like against the rules. Like, you handle that shit.
Y'all want a good topic?
So, what? Eventually,
I'm about to call my father.
I just learned about
something. I don't even want to put him on a damn podcast because he ain't going to let me deal with
it. I just did my thing, so.
Now, are we going to talk about the.
What's it?
Oh, all right, we got
to hurry up. I thought you were going to bring it around. My thing is, do you think that once you find somebody who can essentially, what it's going to take for a woman to take to get your attention, she's going to have to scheme you? And that's really gonna know. That's
he already
really
got his no.
Right. He got his.
His
back.
Baby mom is.
But yeah, like my baby mom, like
they literally
I'm big in, like I'm big getting skinned by females. That's also what started this epic. Like I was once that guy who
but
was.
See, you're different.
Yeah, like,
your situation.
I don't. But no, there's no situation where you got to scheme on each other.
Yeah, like
I didn't even mean scheme in a bad way. But I mean, it doesn't even have to be scheme. Like when you think I'm moving out the back door. I'm thinking, no, I'm talking scheming as like taking your chicken when you go to get her a drink. Hey, baby, go get me a drink, and she take a chicken off your plate.
Ball.
You get what I'm saying? That she have to.
No, yeah, I feel what you said.
She has to attack you in a different way.
That's how me and her that's how she became my baby mom.
No,
me and her.
No.
Like, I feel what you said. Okay. He's not saying so much skin. He's saying that they alike. If me and her alike, like we do the same shit. Me and my baby mom, we do exactly the same shit. Right, I'm with you all the way.
Can I put this in perspective to him real quick?
Go ahead.
Did you think you had to find a girl that liked Dragon Ball Z just as much as you did in order for y'all to mix?
No. I didn't. Well, I promise.
There has to be something, though. There has to be something out there that y'all...
I didn't think my girl would like Dragon Ball Z.
What was something that you had to find?
But that's the thing, is you don't think about it. It's just essentially incoherent.
She's just scheming. It's intriguing.
What's she about to do? No, real life. My girl, I don't have any expectation from my girl. I don't want to sound terrible. I want a little shawty who's gonna listen.
I am who I am.
That's really all I want. I just want my girl to be able to listen to me. I want to be able to have a good conversation. That sounds regular, but I really just want to be able to talk. And I'm impressed by some of this shit when Chelsea may be like, damn, you know what? I might have been wrong about that. Or I'm looking at something differently. Yeah, I can maybe look at something differently or some, you know, some stupid shit or something. I still be like, Chelsea, you fucking crazy and you fucking stupid, whatever. And then later that day, I'd be like,
She's talking about something right here.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, like,
I'm sure, like, 1,000, like... See, what I... Go ahead, my baby mom, like, literally, everybody know, like, Gina, like, me and her, we was rocking for 6 years, like, you feel me? I was loyal to the bone. I did not do nothing. Like, it was just her. I wouldn't even fuck with y'all niggas. I would just literally sit with her. Hey, we have a goody rap night. Now I'm with my girl, bro. I'm like, I was with my girl, like... Went to work, took
that's
care of her, held her down. Like, I mean, I did when we had our flaws.
I do commend you for the fact that you do.
Everybody
do stuff when Chelsea asks you.
Everybody just got their own things. And me, honestly, for real, I got to a certain point after I just got so irritated with the situation. I just said, "Fuck it, I want my own ways." Like, and
like
now I'm like, I gotta get like, you feel me? I'm still trying to have fun. Like, my grandfather and my father and all my older men, they done tapped into my head. But, like, you feel me? We all know I done had a special one, you feel me? That, you feel me? Shit, niggas fucked up. I mean, I can make that situation better.
Right.
You feel me? It's just,
I know myself. I'm not about to go make a situation better because I know I can make it better to get it back, and then just to fuck it up when I still know I'm not done fucking with the juice yet. All right. So when I'm done fucking with the juice, then I can fuck with that. But right now, I ain't about to come back to you because I'm still fucking with the juice. Now you mad? Like I ain't trying to hear that shit.
It ain't right now.
You feel me? When you could have just simply, it ain't no big rush.
I was having a conversation with somebody the other day.
So you feel like he said juice?
Oh, he's relaxed.
I ain't done fucking with the Jews yet. You ain't gonna stop fucking with Jews. Like, look, when I'm done fucking with the Jews, I go home. But until I'm done fucking with the Jews.
Right,
shit. Write that down. We gotta make that a skit. Shit, I'm
gonna stop fucking with the Jews.
I gotta get your credits again.
Let's
go. All right. Speaking of done fucking with the Jews,
but that's what that's
y'all
what I'm
about
saying.
To get ready to get married. I guess y'all don't feel like that, but marriage and age of getting married. Y'all about to be 23. You about to be how old, Chelsea?
23
right now. 23,
okay.
Y'all
I know
Kelly,
nigga.
23.
My bad, bro. No, I guess y'all wasn't the same grade. I'm sorry. But I mean, like, so just getting married, like, at this age, you feel me? Like, what do you think? Like, what was your mindset of just, like, it's just now is the time? And what do you say to all the other couples out there who maybe the way that society is going, they feel like, because, I mean, it's just a stigma. Like, everybody out here, like, ain't nobody got no problem having kids. Like, that's almost, like, a given. You feel me? Like, you fuck with a chick. Like, I remember I asked this girl when I was in high school. She's still a virgin. And she was like, what do you think? I was like, damn. Like, it's like that. Like, we just assuming that motherfucker, everybody fucking now. But I guess, like, that's just the way that it was. So, like, now it's just, like, everybody's just assuming to have a kid. Like, so when are we going to get to a point to where we, like, and, like, motherfuckers is at a certain age where, like, people is at least comprehending and thinking about marriage, you feel me? And like, actually, and what do you recommend? Like, what was maybe some of the signs that you maybe saw? Like, I think I'm gonna have to go ahead and just lock it on that. Like,
you talk to me, you don't tell him.
You think you want to ask her to marry you?
I mean, my views on marriage is a little different than a lot of people. You're right. Like, what you were saying, we're our generation. I hate saying my generation is different than that generation because, I mean, it is. Now, it is factual, but it ain't worse than that generation.
Right.
It's very much so factual.
No, I'm saying.
Or that different.
It's factual. Statistics prove that us as a generation, we're more likely to get married later in our.
But I'm talking about our generation being worse. Versus being, I do agree that it's different. Yeah.
So it is different, but
for sure.
Our parents was having sex around the same age we started having.
Earlier.
They were smoking. They were doing crack. Everything. Like, this is the biggest contradiction. They say you can't get nothing. My bad. Well, I just go ahead.
You just pitch me.
Well, I'm just saying I hate it when they say. I've been around the block once or twice, but at the same time, they say back in my day, we didn't do that shit. Like, it's a contradiction.
That no old folks gonna tell me what the fuck to do. We got a different perspective on a lot of shit. And you got some good points. I'm gonna listen to what you guys are saying, but people get mad when you don't do what you want to. Like, just because I do something differently don't mean I'm not listening to you. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm doing it how I want to do it because it's my perspective on how I live my life.
I think that's what parents totally,
need to understand. A lot of parents do, a lot of parents don't. You know what I'm saying? I ain't even going, you know, this is some shit.
We process information.
Right. Yeah. We were processing this shit differently. But when it comes to this marriage stuff, you know, I'm 23. So I guess I am decently young. I told my homies, you know, I was 8. I think about doing this thing. You know, that thing you want to do when you about to do that thing with your girl, you're trying to make it serious. And they was all like, nigga, you wild. You know what I'm saying? So it came off like, you know what I'm saying? I could see they was like, boy, we got over the time, we got a lot of shit coming, you know, we got this and that. And I looked at it as, since, you know, my granddad was a bishop, I did grow up in the church, and I understand, you know what I'm saying, I got a certain special love, I got a special feeling, I think I got a special feeling for love in my heart, that I'm like, I know when shit is real, or I just feel like I got this super weird feeling that I can't explain it. So my girl, I know I've always had that, but you know, I've always done this bullshit. I done this bullshit here and there, and I'm like, man, you know, this is something I don't want to ever miss my opportunity on. But doing the bullshit, I realized that, like, you know what, I'm not about to let this shit go because I'm fucking being stupid with shit I don't even really fucking care about. You know, like, shit, be fucking stupid. It be stupid. It be like, I talk to my niggas about it, it be like, damn, this ain't really fun for real. This is just being a nigga. And I was like, fuck that. And I tried to get my life together, you know, really commit to this family man shit. And I was like, man, you know what I'm saying?